Hello, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and a visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's That Celebrity Interview.
Good day, Erin Lowry. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Having a fabulous day. I want my audience to know that Erin Lowry is a millennial personal finance expert, and she's here to talk about money, our favorite thing, and the gender gap. All right, Erin, you got our attention. What can you help us with?
Well, for one, you mentioned the gender gap already, and as many people know, millennial women make about 81 cents on the dollar compared to men in the workplace at large. And what that means for millennial women is that, unfortunately, it is going to take us longer to reach our financial goals. And a big one for a lot of millennials is paying off that student loan debt. But we also need to make sure that simultaneously we're investing and saving for our future so we can start to close the investing gap as well as just the wage gap.
Yes, so you've got millennials, and we have one of those who's mired in student debt, and they don't like it. How can we help them?
Well, one thing that SoFi's Women in Investing study or survey actually found is that millennial women do tend to contribute about $200 more per month than millennial men when it comes to paying off their student loan debt. And they pay off that debt about 4 months faster. Now, while this sounds great and it is admirable to get out of debt as quickly as you can, unfortunately, this does sometimes come at the cost of investing and saving for our future at the same time. So we need to make sure that we're balancing our financial priorities and not exclusively paying down debt if it means that we're not saving and investing at the same time.
You're so very, very right. I said we have one millennial. I forgot we have two, and they pretty much finished college around the same time, and my son very lackadaisical about the loans, and my daughter very dogmatic.
And that's pretty common, actually, is that you do see that women, it's not that we have lack of financial health by any means. We certainly are fiscally responsible. But we do tend to very much focus on the things that are within our control. And one thing that we certainly can control is how quickly we pay off our debt. Now, unfortunately, we also found that 56% of millennial women say that they fear the stock market. And that fear is mostly just born out of the fact that they don't know how to get in. They don't know how to start, and they don't know where to go for the right information. And that's, unfortunately, this barrier, this education gap that we have.
So what are some of the strategic steps to help millennial women tackle this student debt? If we're afraid of investing so we can get a little jump on it, what are some of the strategies?
One thing that you can do when it comes to paying off your debt, whether you're a man or a woman, is to look into refinancing. And what refinancing can do is help lower your interest rate, which means you can save hundreds to thousands of dollars over the life of your loan. And that's money that you can be putting towards your other financial goals, whether it's savings or also investing for your future. Another thing I encourage everyone to do is also look into your workplace benefits. You know, do you have an option for an employer-matched retirement plan that maybe you're not taking advantage of or not fully maxing out to the best of your ability, especially when it comes to getting that full match? Now, the thing is looking into a health savings account. And then, of course, everyone, and I know we hate this word, but everyone needs to budget. You need to make sure you know how much money is coming in and how much money is going out so you can make those informed financial decisions for yourself.
And how can we increase financial security for women even when there is a gender pay gap?
Well, one of the things that we need to do is make sure that we are setting goals. And those need to be short, medium, and long-term goals that we can then create investing plans around and make sure that we're in well-diversified portfolios. Because what you want to be investing in completely depends on when you need access to that money. Now, one thing that unfortunately the survey did find is that by and large, 53% of men would invest in the most aggressive plan available to them, but only 38% of women. So we need to make sure that we are understanding our risk tolerance levels and how we need to be investing based on when we need access to that money. And if we're young and we're investing for retirement and it's decades away, we need to be sure to take some risk while we're younger. We can weather the ups and downs of the market.
So what can you do, or the millennial women do, to earn past their base salary? Because they're earning good salaries, but to do all these things, save more, have more, what can they do?
Like you said, we do tend to earn well, even if we're not necessarily getting compensated on the same level as men. But it does come back to the basics. And that is not a fun catch. Oh, it's not a like sexy answer that people necessarily want. But you have to get back to your very basics to figure out both your goals and how you're going to reach your goals. And budgeting has a lot to do with that. Making sure that you're spending in a way that is actually aligned with your values and where you want to see yourself in 1, 2, 3, 5, 10, 50 years from now. And part of that is going to be paying off your debt. Part of it's just going to be saving, but a good chunk of that also needs to be investing.
All right, then. Boy, you're really smart. You probably did good in school.
Thank you. My audience,
we want them to be as smart as you, though. So where can they go online, Erin, and find out more information?
Well, one thing that you can certainly do is check out SoFi Wealth. You can find that at SoFi, SoFi.com. And there you can learn more about how to build a well-diversified portfolio. You can learn about goal setting. And they also help you rebalance in the future to make sure that you're still aligned with those risk tolerance for when you want to take that money out. And it's an app as well, so you can download it on your phone. It can be at the touch of a button.
Erin Lowry, I said she was smart. She's also an author of Broke Millennial. Stop scraping by and get your financial life together. Erin, thanks for gracing the Valder Beebe Show and helping my audience. I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me. It was great to be here.